Dear friends, welcome to part 5 of unit number 4 ES IoT. In this video we are going to study IoT security. This is the last topic of this unit and very generalized topic. Okay, IoT security. As you know, IoT devices in our personal lives, there are many IoT devices we are interacting with in day-to-day activities. Okay, your mobile phone is one of the IoT devices. Okay, and also if you are in home automation or office automation system, you are surrounded with IoT devices. Okay, so these devices are knowingly or unknowingly collecting your personal data, your presence, they are tracing you. Okay, so these devices are at significant risk. Okay, so many of the devices collect huge number of data, and if these devices are compromised or if they have been hacked, in simple language, then this your data will also be at serious risk. Okay, now see, so there are many challenges which are different than the your traditional computer network security. Okay, now many of the devices are connected to computers. If computers are having some flaws, this system completely will collapse. Okay, so we need to provide additional security to this IoT devices. Okay, so this is the generalized information. As you know, we all are surrounded with IoT devices. Okay, now new concept of IoT is Internet of Everything. Okay, so every device is connected to internet. Okay, devices like RFID and sensor nodes have little access control functionality. Okay, now see, these devices, sensor nodes and all these RFID, they are installed on particular application where there is less or no human supervision. Okay, so and many of the cases human beings cannot go to the place where these devices are installed, or for security reasons we don't go there. Okay, so many of the devices are battery operated devices. Okay, so they are in hostile environment and they are independently working there. Okay, so there is huge risk that these devices might get stolen, or somebody may also compromise this device. Okay, and using authentication and authorization attacks, these devices may also be at security threat. Okay, so privacy of these devices itself and your data is very important. Okay, so these are the vulnerabilities in IoT. Okay, these are actually threats for security of IoT. Okay, denial of service attack. Okay, this is distributed denial of service. This is denial of service attack. Unauthorized access. Okay, information corruption, removal or theft of your resource, information disclosure. So all of them are nothing but the security threats to IoT devices. Okay, six security threats or vulnerabilities are there. Okay, so you already know unauthorized access is the access by unauthorized person. Information corruption is the corruption or the misuse of your information. Okay, theft of resource, your communication channel or your device may be stolen. Okay, you may get less bandwidth or less internet connectivity because of some attacks. Okay, then information disclosure, your information may be disclosed to some other third party services or systems. So many of the applications are having privacy policies. Okay, denial of service attack. In this case, the authorized person are not able to get services from the system. Why? Because these systems are flooded with many other unauthorized requests. Okay, so that's why system cannot distinguish between authorized and unauthorized requests. So that's why this attack is called as denial of service attacks. Okay, the same distributed denial of service attack. Okay, here multiple compromised systems are used to target single system. Okay, then this is the example of Cyber Bunker. This organization has launched one attack which was popular for slowing down the internet connection of entire world. Okay, so there are many attacks which were there on internet to slow down internet connection. Also, there were many attacks through some applications to gather your information, privacy information. Okay, the recent one is Zoom meeting app, which is not secured app. Okay, that also been identified as having privacy threat. Okay, these are the requirements, security requirements in IoT. So these are the requirements that sample or the your ideal IoT system should have, the security requirements. Okay, access control, it should be having some access control or using authorized access to particular registered individual. Okay, authentication, it should have identity based authentication, identity establishment, then confidentiality of your data, then all the time availability of information on the system, then trust management. Okay, secure storage of your information, then your system should be tamper resistance, it should be scalable. Okay, so all of them are generalized points. Okay, so flexibility and adaptability, your system should be flexible and it should be adaptable to the surroundings and the several risk factors. Okay, it should overcome this risk factors. Okay, this is the comparison between the traditional IoT system and the new IoT system. Okay, so there were single factor authentication in traditional system. Now as we got to know that this system should get compromised, so there is multiple factor authentication. So many of the times you get multiple factor authentication means even though if you enter your password, you need to provide some more identity of yourself. Okay, so many of the cases in Gmail you might have experienced this thing. If you if you are trying to log in from new system, after entering your password, you are not able to log into your email. It asks you some different questions like mobile number and likewise. Okay, so they are called as two-factor authentication. Then dynamic key distribution, hidden unique identifiers, all of them are the new security requirements of IoT systems. Okay, these are the challenges. So why we need, or why these IoT systems are at high risk? These devices are not reachable, they are kept in hostile environment, they may be lost or stolen. Okay, these devices don't have any crypto engines, or they themselves don't have any security mechanism because they are having less processing power, they are battery operated, so they cannot have large algorithms to run on their own. Okay, then as they are having battery life, so their finite life these devices are having, they are transportable and they may be recognized by many readers. Okay, so these are the challenges, security challenges in IoT system. Okay, so you may find three questions here: IoT security challenge, then security requirements in IoT, and vulnerabilities in IoT. Okay, so very small topic, hope you understood this. Thank you.